because what we're going to get into is a little bit of why the CPA on ClickBank is unique and can offer no caps to your ad spend. So, a little bit of history here. If we're looking at 1998, when I was watching Arthur on PBS because I didn't have cable television, ClickBank is founded. It's purely for rev share, meaning if you get a commission from ClickBank on rev share and a refund happens, you lose that commission as the affiliate. You're going to lose that to make the customer whole, right? We'll fast forward a lot to 2017 when we went to Affiliate World Asia. We heard this Affiliate World thing is pretty cool. We should check it out, not just go to all the American summits. And we came home with hardly any business because we were all offering rev share. All the affiliates wanted CPA. We had been working with plenty of scaled media buyers on rev share. We thought we could make it work and just help them with math and stuff like that. But no, they wanted CPA. They didn't want to take the risk. So we go back to the drawing board. How can we really make CPA work on ClickBank? And we launch a CPA solution in 2021. And that brings us to the end of 2021. If you look at the whole percent of the type of commission paid on ClickBank, CPA represented 3% of the payments going out in 2021. 2022, that grew to 14%. In 2023, we're at around 19% right now. That will probably grow to, I'm going to guess, like 23-ish percent by the end of the year. And what's important to note is that this is not just lateral movement of like a seller doing CPA and now doing rev share and it's the same affiliate. These are new affiliates coming on and almost like shoving into this wedge, not just the wedge staying the same size, right? Their pie chart staying the same. So we've grown tremendously from different types of affiliates now being able to play on the platform in a much different way. And we look at today, there's over 170 offers on ClickBank offering CPA. There's over 400 affiliates being paid a CPA payment. An average CPA is right around $135. So it's a higher average than the platform average. And we'll go into that in a second, because if you look at the 400 affiliates making CPA commissions, that's a very small number of the total affiliates on ClickBank. And that's intentional. We built CPA so a seller could give a specific affiliate a fixed commission per sale, not have it variable, not have refunds come back from it, right? So it's intentional to be targeted to the big affiliates that can drive a lot of volume, who really need CPA to be able to scale and trust that their commissions are going to stay the same. Because if you look at how CPA usually works, usually if I'm an offer owner and I want to offer CPL or CPA, and I'm not going to do it self-hosted, I want to go to a network, I need to offer that network, or I need to like pay into an escrow for that network, right? I need to give them 50 grand, 100 grand, whatever it might be. They're going to draw down from that amount to pay their affiliates. Or they're going to be invoicing me daily almost to make sure their affiliates are getting paid, right? Because they need the cash flow to be there. What can happen with that is cash flow constraints. Because if that CPL payment's going out, but I haven't monetized those leads yet myself, we might have paid out 75K of that 100, but I've only recouped 25K so far of the leads coming in because they're mixed quality or I'm not good at monetizing those leads. The affiliates want to scale more, but now we're drawing down to the cap issue, right? And the cash flow constraints are coming in. Or things are going really well, and the affiliates want to really scale a CPA offer, but now the merchant might be hitting merchant processing issues, merchant processing caps, where they can't get enough merchant processing to actually collect credit card info, or the rates are getting wonky. Maybe their chargebacks are too high. They start losing merchant processing. So different caps and cash flow constraints come into play here quite frequently. And you start end up managing all these caps and mids, which just creates frustration when you're an affiliate trying to scale something, and you have to go over here because you get 100 leads a day here, and 1,000 leads a day here, 50 sales a day here, but you want to be able to send as much as you can, but you can't, because you're trying to wheel and deal and just find out who even has this offer to begin with. Versus some different CPA advantages, which would be higher payouts, right, because these average order values are climbing and increasing over time, fast payouts, because the money is in the pocket, and no need to qualify the lead because they did it themselves by purchasing something, right? So you've moved down the stream from a CPL action to an actual sale, and now the customer, the seller, the merchant, the ClickBank, for example, can pay out much faster because we can assure that the quality is better. Because if you move to a sale point, you don't have to worry about lead stuffing. You have to worry about merchant processing and mids and kind of chargebacks and fraud. But a lot of that's cut out by the tools and software we have already built in, so we can just focus on scaling. And then there's no caps on ClickBank anyway. We'll cover why that is here. So on ClickBank, we unlock CPA by doing a few things. The whole platform is still RevShare, right? So all the offers are set up on RevShare, meaning that transactions can come back from you. But what's going to happen is that since ClickBank is the merchant of record, we have all the sales data. We know the initial checkout value. We know the average order value. We know the lifetime value if there's any recurring billing built in those products. We know the refund rate, the chargeback rate, the fraud rates. We know the cost of goods. We know the fulfillment costs. And we have a CPA calculator that our sellers use that once there's enough sales data from their rev share funnel, we can turn on CPA for them. They use the CPA calculator to set a max CPA they can pay. That's a healthy amount. That's not going to run into them running out of cash, right? So this is a max CPA we help them find. So there's a surety and assurance that they can scale that indefinitely. Now, the kicker here is, right, if I am a seller and I give an affiliate, say, a max CPA of like $150, and that's like really high for me, that's like the upper end of that cap, and that affiliate is now driving refunds at double the average rate for people, those refunds are hitting me three times as hard as they would on RevShare. And those are going to draw down my reserves on ClickBank very quickly if they're a big affiliate driving a lot of traffic. If that were to happen, and the CPA, if the account was good, were to go to zero, CPA would turn off, which sounds like a cap, but then it just defaults to RevShare. So you still have commissions coming in. You just won't see like 150, 150, 150 for every sale. You might see 40, 200, 186, right? You're going to see some really random numbers start coming through, which might mess up your algorithms a bit, but you're still going to be recouping your ad costs on the ad spend you're doing. You're not just losing out and hitting a cap and having to pause campaigns, and you just burned a bunch of cash in ad spend. So looking at a high converting funnel for what these affiliates are actually doing on ClickBank, they're keeping it simple. I don't like to say stupid, but I just did. They get to know the offer intimately on the platform, right, and what they're promoting, and they're creating their ads and bridge pages. And so what they're doing is, like, this is Jen LeCompte. She's a Diamond Media buyer. She's doing over 5 million, well over 5 million on YouTube. She's watching the VSL that she's promoting. She's reading the TSL. She's promoting that in depth. She's making ads and landers and bridge pages built with those hooks in mind and really taking into account the unique copy and ranking unique ads to run on YouTube. If we look at an example here, we're going to look at a native example because that's easier to show than a YouTube ad. But right, native ad example on ESPN, just scroll through there and grab one. Customer's going to click on this, go to a very simple bridge page. Obviously, I've modified the bridge page, so I'm not just sharing someone else's scaled thing, because this is a real page they're using. So the format's the same. It might be a weight loss looking video. The headline's going to be much better than what I made, not just someone as a stunt double in Pineapple Express. But then if they click on play or click here, that's where the actual affiliate tracking link is to the offer.